are. We're here with Phil, the Voice Davey. Phil is the announcer for tonight. Phil, you do shows all over the country, all over the state of Michigan. What's going to happen tonight? What's this show going
to
have for us?
Looking forward to one of Greg's shows, UCF shows, because he always has at least 20 fights. Greg never has a problem filling his card. So lots of really willing fighters that are willing to fight for Greg because he puts on a good, safe show. And he always has great, great matchups. His card maker does a great job of matching up his fighters, which eventually gives him a good card. So I'm excited about working with Greg. So.
How many of shows do you usually do a month?
Well, it depends on the time of the season. Right now, I'm stacked rack. I'm doing shows just about every weekend right now. I'm involved with about 6 or 7 different promoters and having a great time working with all of them.
Okay. Tell us about how you got started as an announcer. You were just telling me about it. You started out as a fighter, and it's evolved from there. How'd that happen for you?
I've got a traditional martial arts background. I've got a couple of different black belts. I'm first dan in Wing Kung Fu Sudo, and second dan in Taekwondo, ITF Taekwondo. And I did a lot of traveling around and doing international sparring, full contact sparring, point sparring, Taekwondo, and Wing Kung Fu Sudo, did some forms and things like that in tournaments. And always been involved in the fight club. Fight game in one capacity or another. So it was a great way for me to stay involved in the great sport of combat, although I can't compete anymore. It's sustained concussions and kind of old and beat up. So this is really the best way for me to stay involved.
Just a natural progression then?
Natural progression. I'm silver tongued, as they say, and I love the sport. I've got a passion for the sport. And I just love being involved in this. Like I said, a great way for me to stay involved in the great sport of mixed martial arts.
Okay. You have your black belts in, is it three styles?
In two different styles.
Two styles?
Kung Fu Sudo, it's three in martial art, and then ITF Taekwondo.
Okay, tell us a little about the philosophies of those. You're not fighting anymore, but how did the philosophies from those help you when you were competing?
Well, any time that you're involved in a traditional martial art, Tom, it encompasses all of the things that really should make you a better person. It talks about, we preach honesty, we preach being honest to yourself, and integrity, trustworthiness, and focus. And by applying all of those elements to your life, as either somebody who's just sparring in a tournament, or trying to earn your belt ranks up to first on black belt, it hones you as a person. You can carry those traits through the rest of your life.
Do you think that it's helped you be successful in other areas of your life? Is it carried over? How does it carry over?
Well, it carries over in many different ways. It reminds me to remain humble, to try to focus on my family and decide why I'm doing things. And the reason I'm doing things is to be a better person. And that's what traditional martial arts teaches.
Do you think that still exists with the MMA today? I know there's not as much focus on the kind of metaphysical or the spiritual part of it, but it's still, you still learn those lessons through hard work and dedication. You can't go into a cage and fight somebody and come out of it the victor unless you've prepared better, had more experience, things like that. Do you think that those lessons still exist?
It definitely does. The majority of the mixed martial arts schools that you see these guys training at today it's usually derivative of some traditional martial arts that has an influence on the instructor that's teaching. So it's real obvious when I see a camp that has a traditional martial artist in the background, because you see their fighters have respect, you see they're humble. Unfortunately, a lot of times with the amateurs, mixed martial artists, you can also see the camps that don't embody those same principles. You see a lot of cockiness, you see a lot of disrespect, you see a lot of angst and anger, where that none of it should really be in place in martial arts, even mixed martial arts, especially mixed martial arts.
Do you think that, like you said, the cockiness and then those other things that you see sometimes from the fighters that aren't as experienced, does that hold them back? My guess would be it would keep them from being able to get good training partners, and
I believe so. Anytime you come from a good camp that teaches honor, respect, tradition, then of course as a fighter, it'll take you further. Because if you run around and you're hot-headed and you're not being taught those traditional, respect and honor, then your career will not go as far. I'm a proponent of teaching those elements, even with mixed martial arts.
great. All right. You said that Greg Aarons puts on one of the better shows in MMA. What should we keep an eye out for tonight? The fights are going to be great, but what else has he got going on that's exciting?
Greg's got a lot of things going on. He's partnering up with a couple of different partners right now, from what I understand. They've got some pretty big plans. I'm not really privy to those plans as of yet. I am just the announcer and kind of revel in that. I used to promote shows, and I really felt that by going with my strengths, which is just the announcing, it served me better. I know that Greg has got some great, great things planned. Looking forward also to April 18th, the Palace of Auburn Hills. I'll be announcing the Impact Fight League, which is the Donna Frio production show.
Okay. Anything else you have going on that people can keep an eye out for?
There's plenty going on. If you want to find out more about my schedule, where I'm going to be, and where these fights are going to be, go to PhilTheVoiceDavey.com.
All right, great. Thank you very much, Bill.
You're welcome.